The next question comes from snowboard YouTuber via Instagram, Jonathan Buckhouse. Are Amazon companies killing snowboard brands? No, they're not killing brands. They're taking a piece of a shrinking pie that they shouldn't.
Mm-hmm.
And the issue that I have is the amount of these bullshit fly-by-night fucking companies making goddamn knockoff bullshit that hurts you, especially goggle brands.
Goggle brands,
which I know you're sponsored by one Buckhouse, and you're doing giveaways with them. You are hurting snowboarding by promoting them. You, Casey, every vlogger that takes a $200 or $300 or $400 paycheck to promote some bullshit Amazon brand like Outdoor Master or Awenya or fucking Zionor.
A-bomb.
Yeah. Like any of those bullshit open mold brands or those shitty ass gloves that they're making, at least they're... Or the fucking No Bad Day bindings that are just a fucking 3D scan of a Strata and a Force combined.
Mm-hmm.
Any of those things, you're hurting. You're not killing a snowboard brand. You're hurting. And you're hurting snowboarders because those goggles are frying your eyes.
Yeah.
Those gloves, who the fuck knows what's in those things?
Mm-hmm.
Let's see what else is up there. Those No Bad Day bindings, like, they're not forged aluminum. That's a stamped aluminum. So you're taking a step back about 30 years in binding technology.
Yeah, they might explode.
You know, so it's doing that. But the bigger issue is the influencers that don't know their ass from a hole in the ground when it comes to gear,
mm-hmm.
promoting them. And you see people getting burned and you see people using shit products. And I loved it. I had a conversation with a guy in DMs on Instagram. He's like, well, I've got these cheap ones and these are great. And once I started explaining to him distortion and light and infrared light and everything, he's like, wait, what? And I was like, and he's like, how do you know this much? And I was like, I paid $4,500 to get my eyes fixed. Cause when I was growing up, I used shitty ass goggles coupled with hereditary and stuff. I fried my fucking eyes though, basically.
Mm-hmm.
And my eye doctor told me that there is some weird damage on the back of one of them, to the point it looks like I stared into a welding torch, he thinks. And I was like, well, I didn't do that, but I kind of have an idea of what happened. It's my older brother's fault. And there's some damage in there, which luckily we were able to catch and correct. And now mm-hmm. I've got perfect vision, but I had to pay for it. And I can see it, even in some of my higher-end goggles. Like my Dragons, in the dead center of the lens, and it's only if I catch it with the right eye and I'm looking across, there is a ripple in the lens, and I can see the distortion, but it's like Drop sent us a bunch of gloves and goggles to test. The gloves, like, that's what Drop's known for. Gloves, they've got that dialed.
Their gloves are solid.
Solid. Fucking solid. But their goggles, they have a smoky hue to them
mm-hmm.
in the lens, which is distortion. And when I was talking to the guy... It's a clarity issue. He's like, oh, I've had one other person, and I was like, did they have eye surgery? And he's like, I think he said that they had LASIK or something, which I didn't have LASIK, I had PRK. But I noticed it, and I can pick up a low-end, like, Scott goggle and be like, stamped lens, and pick it up and be like, okay, fine. And then I go like this, and it's like, distortion! In the second, you can spot that, but...
That's the thing that people don't understand is you put on those shitty goggles that you just ordered off Amazon, you wear them for 10 minutes, like... Are you going to notice it right away? You might not, but it's the clarity, it's the UV protection that they have. They can put whatever they want up. They can say it has UV protection, but they don't actually have to back that up. Yeah. That's one of the big issues. So you don't know if you're frying your eyes or not, because that company has, like, good luck if your eyes do get fried trying to figure out even who to sue.
Well, you should just take onus on the fact that you did this shit. Right. But...
And, like, that's the reason goggles cost what they cost, is because in order to get the right amount of clarity that doesn't cause eye strain, in order to get lenses that don't have any distortion to them or have minimal distortion, to do decentering, to build these molds, in order to do high-end goggles, costs money.
Yeah.
That's why they cost what they cost. So if you are getting something that doesn't cost that, you're sacrificing something. So what are you sacrificing?
That, and then the fact that you've got these Chinese brands that have access to these factories because their family owns it or someone in their family or mm-hmm. whatever. And, you know, I get poorly written emails that'll be like, my name is Jeanette and I'm from company blah, blah, blah. We really like your YouTubes, mm-hmm. not YouTube, videos, and we would like you to promote with reviews of this product. And it's like, no, I'm not fucking interested. I did it. I for a while there, I was just collecting goggles from companies. I was like, I'm not even going to review these. I just want to do a whole video and be like, shit. Mm-hmm. And I get it. You've got an Amazon affiliate link. You're trying to make that. I think Amazon's a 5% commission. It might be less than that. It might be 3%. I can't remember. It might be more than that. I don't know. But you're trying to get that. You want the money. But the problem is you're selling yourself out to a shit company so that you can take advantage of your viewership that is trying to support you. So you're like, well, if I buy it from this person who's going to do this, it just ends up hurting you. You need to learn when to draw the line in the sand and mm-hmm. say, I'm not going to do this. I'm not. That's what's hurting snowboarding. When I see people giving shit advice, that hurts snowboarding. Mm-hmm. When I see people being like, no, fuck this. Just buy some Zionor goggles off Amazon for $30. Don't buy those Oakley. And here's the funny thing about mainstream, like, solid goggle companies. You can always find a fucking closeout at the start of the season on them for absurdly cheap. And the technology really hasn't changed that much.
No.
They're still solid.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's a reason I still rock goggles from, like, 2-3 years ago. I took care of them. The lenses are good. It's great. The foam is still good on everything. I can use those.
Yeah.
I haven't killed them. But these Amazon companies that are just making shitty-ass knockoffs, that's what they are, is shitty-ass knockoffs. And they figured out that they can put it on the Amazon store place and they can use other people to do it, or they can send it to Amazon and have it drop-shipped through someone else's store. That's all it is. It's not doing anything beneficial for snowboarding. And I know some dumbass somewhere is going to leave me a fucking comment on this and tell me I'm wrong and they're right. Here's the difference between me and you, buddy. I've sold every mainstream thing under the sun. I've been to a lot of clinics. I've seen a lot of technology. I have been there and gotten to witness firsthand. I've been able to look at it and go, no, this isn't right. This isn't that and that. I mean, sorry, dude. Yeah, I get it. Snowboarding's expensive. You want to save money. You got to cut corners somewhere, somehow. Fucking with your eyes? Probably not the best, especially down the road when you're all fucking blind in your 50s.
Yeah, you only get two of them, and there's not really easy ways to fix them.
Yeah. Let me tell you about eye surgery. It was quick, it was painless, and the recovery took a fucking year for PRK. And there's a new surgery out.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, it gets better and better. But I paid $43.65 to get my eyes fixed. I don't know how many people end up having that kind of cash laying around to go do that.
Yeah, not often.
So, yeah, that's kind of how I feel about these Amazon companies. Like, every time they email me, I'm like, just send me whatever. You don't see me promoting it. You see me shit-talking it.
Yeah.
And that's where it's going to be. But if you're taking a $200, $400, $500 paycheck to use your influence to sell it, there's a fucking problem there.
Yeah.
And so anyone watching this, be warned. I mean, if someone suddenly comes out and be like, hey, this company's hooking me up with these goggles, and you've never heard of that fucking company, that's influencer marketing at its rawest form right mm-hmm. there. Like, believe me, I could take paychecks from a lot of shitty brands, and my life would be really well because I could be like, no, I want $10,000. And for some reason, they'd probably come up with that.
They probably would.
So,
yeah.
Fuck that. Like,
yeah.
So. Don't do snowboarding a disservice. Don't hurt snowboarding. Do everything you can to make it better. These inferior products do not make it better.
Short answer is, are they killing snowboard brands? No, but it sure as hell ain't helping.